Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with ordering of fractions. So let's start. So we'll be ordering from least to greatest as well as from greatest to least. So let's start. So let's start with the first one. So we have got four fractions for ordering. Okay, so what is the technique? The technique is, first of all, we need to have a common denominator in all the fractions. Okay, so we can see the various kinds of denominators we have is 8, 4, 2, right? We need to have a common value for that. Okay, so how we can do, we can find out the LCM of it, okay, or we can just check the multiples like this. So this is it, we will try to make this it. So 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8. So 2 fours are 8, we can get this 8. It is 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So this also we can make 8. Okay, so let's try to make all the fractions as the base or the denominator having 8. So this is having 8, this is all right. If we see this, this is 4, right? So what we'll do is we'll multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. Okay, in that scenario, this will become as 3 to the 6, and the denominator will become as 8. In this one, you can see this is 2, right? So to make it 8, we need to multiply by 4. So we'll multiply by 4 in the numerator as well. So it will be 20 upon 8. Let's see the last one. Last one is already having 8 denominators, so we can write it like this. Okay, now we can compare the numerator. Normally we do. Okay, so which is the least one? The least one is, we can say it is 4, right? Other is having higher value, so we can write 4 by 8 at first. That is the least one. The next least one, we have two similar values, that is 6 by 8 and 6 by 8. So we can write any 6 by 8, then 6 by 8. Then we can see this is the one that is having the highest value, that is 20 by 8. Okay, so this is how you can order the fractions from least to greatest, that is having common denominator and then seeing the numerator for the least value to the greatest value. Now let's arrange from the greatest to the least. Okay, the concept is same. First, we have to have a common denominator for all the fractions. Okay, so this is having 20. So if we multiply 5 by 4, we'll get 20. If we multiply 4 by 5, we'll get 20. If we multiply 10 by 2, we'll get 20. Okay, so we can have 20 as denominator. So first, let's try with this one. So to make it 20, we need to multiply it by 4 in the numerator and in the denominator. So it will become as 16 upon 20. All right. In the second fraction, we can see it is having 4. To make it 20, we need to multiply by 5. In the numerator and in the denominator, so it will become as 15 upon 20. Let's see the third one. The third one is having 10 as denominator. To make it 20, we need to multiply it by 2 in the numerator and in the denominator, so it will become as 10 upon 20. Let's see the fourth one, that is 11 by 20. So we'll leave it like this because it is already having 20 as base. Okay, so we are now having a common denominator. What we need to do is we need to see the numerator for the highest value. So the numerator with the highest value is 16, right? So we will write 16 by 20. Next one, let's see, next one is 15 by 20, so we'll write 15 by 20. Next one is 11 by 20, we'll write 11 by 20. Next one is 10 by 20, we'll write 10 by 20. Okay, so now we have got the arrangement from the greatest to the least. The concept was same, that is, first of all, we need to have a common denominator for all the fractions, and then we can compare the numerator for the greatest to the least. Okay, so this was all. So if you found the video helpful, please do the like button. If you have any doubts, you can feel free to comment down and ask. Okay, and thanks for watching.